My name is Chris Melesinos, and I'm the guest curator for the Art of Video Games exhibition at the Smithsonian American Art Museum. So one might ask the question, why are video games in an art museum? And for me, the answer is very simple. Video games are an amalgam of traditional art. Within video games, we observe illustration, painting, composure, all of the same things that we hold up as traditional art. It has never been a question that video games would be in an art museum. It was, at what point would we see them? So this exhibition does not attempt to draw a line in the sand, put a stake in the ground, and say, games, video games are art. What I wanted to do was illustrate the impact that video games have had as an art form in American culture over its 40-year existence. So the exhibition is divided into three distinct areas. The first area is a discovery area where you'll actually hear from the designers of these games, from designers that started at the very beginning on the Atari VCS all the way to designers working in the medium today. From those interviews, you will actually hear their inspiration, their philosophy, their passion, their, you know, what inspires them to build within the video game medium. In the second area, we've provided five games that are playable by the public: Pac-Man, Super Mario Brothers, The Secret of Monkey Island, Myst, and Flower. And these five games all did something very different within their respective eras. So for example, in Super Mario Brothers, this was the first time that American public had been given into their dens this massively expansive world of discovery and wonder. It offers this world up to the player, allows them to approach it from a variety of different perspectives, and the world presented itself as something familiar. You run on the ground and there are walls to jump on, but every once in a while you'd hit a brick that took you to an area that was unexpected, or there was something that was hidden in the world beyond your sight, but if you just played within the environment long enough, you would tease that component of the story out. And then in the third area, 20 systems that really stood as anchors within their respective generations. We don't start at the very beginning of the earliest systems. We wanted to go ahead and start with one of the ones that was the most popular of the beginning era, and that's the Atari VCS, released in 1977. And we followed that trajectory all the way up to the PlayStation 3, which is the most current system that we have in this exhibition. I would hope that anyone that comes to visit this exhibition comes in with an open mind. Video games are still such a nascent art form. It's only been 40 years that video games have been present in society. What we're putting on display here is the outpouring of artistry, imagination, and thought that has been collected over generations and now finally being imparted to the world.